Not yet started. Wait, wait, wait. Just a minute. Not started there. బాగానే చెప్పింది 5 మినిట్స్ అయింది యా సీ హియర్ వీఆర్ టాకింగ్ అబౌట్ వర్క్ డన్ కదా సో హియర్ ఎనీ ఫోర్స్ అప్లైడ్ ఆన్ ద ఆబ్జెక్ట్ ఇఫ్ ద ఆబ్జెక్ట్ గెట్ డిస్ప్లేస్మెంట్ ఇఫ్ ద ఆబ్జెక్ట్ గెట్ డిస్ప్లేస్మెంట్ సో వీ కెన్ సే వర్క్ సెట్ టు బి డన్ బై ద ఫోర్స్ అండర్స్టాండ్ Once again, I'm repeating my statement. Any force acting on the body so that if the body position is changed, with that we have some displacement. So in this case, work said to be done. So how can you define the work done now? Any body changes the displacement, having the displacement by application of the force, then work said to be done. So as a result, we can write mathematically the work done as work done equal to force into displacement. As a mathematically, how can you write the work done? Force into displacement. But observe that this work done is a scalar quantity, but force is a vector quantity, even displacement also vector quantity. So that this is a scalar quantity, which means what is the product between the force and displacement in this case? The product between force and displacement is dot product. So that we are having finally a scalar quantity. So finally our conclusion is what? Work done is a scalar quantity. Work done is a scalar quantity. And this is a general formula for work done. This is a general formula for work done. And the units are for work done. Units for work done is SI units are joules. CGS units are erg. SI units are joule, CGS units are what? Erg. And here relation between joule and erg is 1 joule is equal to 10 power 7 erg. 1 joule is equal to how many ergs? 10 power 7 x. So this is the relation between work done and what? Work done and SI units and CGS units. It is utilized for converting the one system of units to other system of unit. And yes, finally, what is the conclusion you made? Any force applied on the object, if the object get displacement, we can say work said to be done. And the formula for work done is F is equal to F bar dot S bar. And it is a what kind of quantity? It is a scalar quantity. And the what is the units for work done? What is the units for work done? Joule. And the CGS system is erg. This is a relation between joule and erg. Got my point? Now, from this relation, let me take equation 1. From equation 1, work done is equal to, you can write even Fs cos theta. Work done equal to Fs cos theta. So this is the other formula for work done. So here F means force applied on the object, S means displacement of the object, and theta is angle between force and displacement. Force and displacement. Theta is the angle between what and what? Force and displacement. Got my point?
Yes, sir.
By having this angle, depends upon this angle, we define work done are three types. Okay, we define work done are three types. So write down types of work done. So write down, keep a heading, types of work done. Types of work done. According to physics, when you will have the work done, when you have the work done, look at the once again. By application of the position of the body, changing the position of the body, then only we can say work said to be done. If you, even though you apply the force, if there is a no change in the, there is a no change in the position, so that is cannot call as a work done. Understand? So body must be have some displacement, then only we will say work said to be done. If even though body is not moving, even though if not apply the force, so displacement happen, so that is cannot call as a work done. Even though mental, whatever the we are doing the work with mental our brain, that is cannot call as a work done according to the physics. Okay, that is IT engineers are doing mental work, right? So with IQ they are doing the work. That work done cannot call as a work according to the physics. We cannot define that work as a work done according to the physics. Okay, your mother is cooking or lifting some weights, that we can call as a work. Understand? And stirring the spoons, okay, to mix the vegetables or something, so that is also we can consider as a work done. But whatever the fathers or mothers doing our brain, that is cannot call as a work done. Even though you are writing, for example, you are reading. Reading means you are doing something, but that something cannot call as a work done according to the physics. Okay, but we feel that we are doing something, but according to the physics, that is nothing. But with whatever we are doing with our brain, that is nothing for according to the physics. Got it? So now let's talk about the types of work done based on the angle. You know, just now I explained work done is equal to Fs cos theta. Understand? Work done is equal to Fs cos theta. So here let me take the first one. If angle is 0 degrees. What is mean angle is 0 degrees? If theta is 0 degrees, when theta is 0 degrees, what going to be your work done here? Work done is equal to Fs. What is angle here? Cos 0. What is the value of cos 0? Cos 0 is not 0. Cos 0 is 1. So we have F into S. That is called positive work done. This is called
positive work done.
So how can you show in a diagrammatic representation of this work? See, this is a object. This is an object, and you are applying the force along this direction, and also having the displacement. This is mass, this is a mass, also having the displacement in the same direction. If the object moves in the direction of the applied force, then the work done by the force is a positive. Understand? The object motion, applied force direction, both are same, then we call it is a positive work done. Understand? Same way, Next, go for the next application, next case, next one, second one is, theta is 180 degrees. Theta is 180 degrees. When theta is 180 degrees, what is the meaning in it? So let us assume the force is acting this direction, and the displacement happened in this direction for the body. What is the angle between force and displacement vector here? 180. When 180, what is the work done here? Work done is equal to W is equal to, tell me, F into S cos my 180. Cos how much? 180. Cos 180. W is equal to F S cos 180 is minus 1. Understand? Then W is equal to minus F S. This is a negative work done. This is a negative work done. So when you will get the negative work done? When you will get the positive work done? You will get the positive work done, applied force and displacement are in the same direction. And when you will get a negative work done, applied force direction and displacement direction, both are in opposite direction, then we can say the work done is what? Negative. So here, finally, till now what is the questions? So what is the things we have? We have learned positive work done and we have learned negative work done. Understand? So similar way, one more type also there. The one more type. I'll give the example. Okay, now. So here, next one is if theta is equal to 90 degrees. Theta is equal to 90 degrees, which means that when theta is equal to 90 degrees, work done is equal to Fs cos 90. Understand? Fs cos 90. So W is equal to become what? 0. Understand? W is equal to, because cos 90 is 0. So when this total term is 0, this term also 0. So finally you will get work done is equal to 0. When work done is equal to 0, so what is the thing you will have here? This is your surface, smooth surface. Imagine smooth surface. This is the normal reaction. This is the force applying. In this direction you have displacement. In this direction you have displacement. In this direction you are applying the force. Then in this case, what is the angle between force and displacement? 90 degrees. Then in this case, you will have 0 work done. So this is now 0 work. So finally, with this 3, what is the conclusion you made? Work can be positive, work can be negative, work can be 0. Because in all the 3 types, what are the 3 types of work done? One is positive work. One more is what? Negative work. Next one is what?
Zero work.
When do you have a positive work? Applied force direction. And the displacement direction, both are in same direction, will have positive work done. Now when do you have negative work done? Applied force direction, displacement direction, both are opposite direction, will have negative work done. Zero work done means what? Applied force direction and displacement direction, both are 90 degrees, then we will get work done is 0. Okay, we have one more. In another way also you will get the 0 work done. For example, you are pushing the wall is not displacing, since you will get over there also 0 work done. In that way we will define. So in here with 90 degrees also we define the work done. Got my point. Now let's take the examples. See, I'm having a object. This is the object. This object having mass m, and this object is on the rough surface. This object is on the rough surface. Here I applied a force F. When I applied the force F, can you tell me how many forces are acting on this body by observing this? How many forces are acting on the body?
Three, sir.
What are they?
Applied force.
Yeah, applied force acting this direction. normal reaction act in this direction. As the body is moving this direction, in which direction frictional force will act? Frictional force will act in this direction. Mg is acting this direction. These many forces are acting on the body. These many forces, this is Mg, this is normal reaction, this is applied force, this is a friction force. These many forces are acting on the body, but what is the work done by all the forces? See here, this totally, this body is moved some distance because of this applied force. The body is moved some distance. This body moved some displacement. So the displacement by the body, you can take S. The displacement by the body, what?
Yes.
When the displacement by the body is S, then one by one questions I'll ask. First one is, work done by applied force. So what is the work done by the applied force?
Positive.
I'm asking magnitude. What is the formula?
Fs cos theta.
Work done equal to Fs cos theta. Very good. Then the applied force direction, displacement, both are in same direction or opposite direction?
Same direction.
So theta will be how much? Theta. Theta is? What is the theta? Applied force direction, displacement direction, both are in same direction. Then what is the angle between?
0 degrees.
Zero. Then what is the answer you have here? F into S. So this is a positive work done. Similar way, second one is work done by friction. Work done by friction. What is the work done by friction? Friction force is F here. What is the work done by friction? Here, what is the formula again? Work done is equal to W is equal to, tell me. W is equal to Fs cos theta. But the displacement is in which direction? This direction. Force, the friction force is acting this direction. What is the angle between friction force and displacement? What is the friction force is in this direction?
180 degrees, sir.
Displacement in this direction. So this is how much angle?
180 degrees.
When 180 degrees, what is the work done here? Work done is equal to friction force into displacement into minus 1. Finally, work done equal to minus F into S. Understand?
Yes, sir.
Now, same way, one more thing. Work done by the normal reaction. Work done by normal force. So here, when you are observing the things here, when you are observing the things on the body, normal reaction acting this direction.
Yes, sir.
And displacement of the body is this direction. What is the angle between them?
90 degrees.
Apply work done formula. Work done equal to Fs cos theta. Work done is equal to F into S. Cos 90 is 0, so the work done is how much? Amma?
Zero
work. Similar way, work done by gravitational force. Work done by gravitational force. What is the work done by gravitational force? What is the work done by gravitational force? Amma?
Zero.
How zero? Here, gravitational force acting this direction, that is called Mg. And along this direction, what is there?
Displacement.
Displacement. What is the angle between them?
90 degrees.
90 degrees. So again, W is equal to, tell me, F into S cos theta. So W is equal to F into S cos 90 degrees. So what is the answer here? Work done. Zero. So this is zero work. So when you are having the work done is zero, work done is positive, work done is negative. Observe the things here. So in this situation, the work done by the applied force is how much? Positive or negative?
Positive.
Work done by the friction force?
Negative.
Negative. Work done by the wow.
Yeah.
Work done by the normal and the gravitational force are
zero.
So this is the way we will define the for every situation. This is the way for by all the work done by the all the forces will calculate. Understand? So here, what is the net work done by the body on the body? Net work done is equal to work done by the applied force plus work done by the friction force plus work done by the normal force plus work done by the weight, work done by the gravitational force. What is the work done by the applied force?
Positive.
F into S. What is the work done by the friction force?
Minus.
So here it will become minus F into S. Work done by the normal reaction is zero. Work done by the gravitational force is zero. Finally, net work done is equal to F minus F into displacement. Understand? But here, what is F minus, capital F minus small f? Capital F minus small f is nothing but net force. So net work done is equal to net applied force into displacement. So this is how we will define the work done. What is? No. Completed. Next, I'll give some questions to you. The first question is: an object, a force is applied 50 newton so that the object displaced so that the object is displaced 7 meters. Find work done on the object. Find out what is the answer. What is the answer? Find the work done. What is the value?
50 joules.
How do you know it?
The force of the object is the displacement.
Work done is equal to solution. What is the solution here? Work done is equal to Fs cos theta. Work done is equal to what? Fs cos theta. So work done is equal to, how much is the force I am applying here?
50
newton. So how much is the displacement happened here?
7 meters.
7 meters. What is the angle between this force and the 7 meter? What is the angle between this force and the 7 meters? Not 90, 0, 0, 0. So here this is an object, in this direction we are applying force, and in this direction only we the object having the displacement, so 7 meters. So totally 350 joules is your answer. How many joules here? 350 joules. All done? Yeah, this is some example problem. Let's know now work done by gravitational force. Work done by what? Gravitational force. Keep a heading. Now this is a mass. This is a mass. On this mass I am applying a force F. Okay. When I am applying the force F, by applying the force F, we are lifting the mass M for a height H. We are lifting the mass. How much height? We are lifting the mass. How much height? H height. When you are lifting the mass H height, what is the work done by the gravitational force? What is the work done by the gravitational force? The work done by the gravitational force is, what is the formula? Work done is equal to force into displacement into cos theta. Am I right? So work done is equal to, here how much is the gravitational force, how much is the quantity of gravitational force is acting on the body? That is called mg, kada? Mg, here also mg is acting this direction, applied force is acting this direction. So we are only talking about gravitational force, so you have to consider just only the gravitational force. What is the gravitational force here? Instead of F you write mg. Got my point? Now by application of when mg is acting, how much is the displacement of the object here? The displacement happened along the vertical or horizontal? How much is the displacement happened in the vertical direction?
H meters.
H meters. So you can write mg h. Understand? You will write mg h. When it is mg h, what is the angle between the mg and the h? H is upward direction, mg is downward direction. What is the angle between h and mg? 180 degrees. So cos is equal to cos 180 degrees. Finally, mgh minus 1. So finally, minus mgh. So what is the conclusion you made here? The conclusion made here, work done by the gravitational force is negative or positive when it is moving upper direction? Negative work done. So when the object is moving upper direction, work done by the gravitational force is negative. Understand?
Yes, sir.
Similar way, work done by the applied force. Here two forces are acting on the body. One is due to gravitational force, one is applied force. So what is the work done by the applied force here? If you are applying the applied force is F, displacement by the body is H. And the angle between that H and F is 0 degrees, so you will have positive value. So work done by the applied force is positive, work done by the gravitational force is negative. Understand?
Yes, sir.
Yeah. Order? Now, in this case, I will ask one question, application part. So, a porter is lifting an object of mass 10 kg through a height of 11 meters. Find work done by gravitational force. Work done by the gravitational force. Tell me the answer. Tell me the answer. How do you write the answer? How do you know that answer? So draw the free body diagram of the mass which is lifting by the porter. How many kg mass we are lifting?
10 kg.
10 kg. When 10 kg on this body, how much is the gravitational force will act if it is 10 kg? M into G kada, M value is 10, G value you can take 10, totally, how many degrees, how many newtons force here, 100 newtons, with this 100 newtons, acting downward direction, but we are lifting how many meters height here, 11 meters, so work done by the gravitational force is equal to MGH, MG value is 100, H value is 11, totally, what is the answer? 1100 joules is a work done on the object. Got my point?
Sir, can you show them before the exam that you got some points?
Yeah. This one, right?
Yes, sir. Hello? Yes, sir.
Completed?
Yes.
Next, this is also you're asking to next one. No, this one.
Yes.
Anyhow, I'll stop the session for today. Okay. In the next class, we'll continue energy terms as well as some other application part. Okay, na?
Okay, sir.
Bye.